So a couple weeks ago, I put out a video talking about the big differences between Integromat and Zapier. Now, if you don't know about this, these are two of the most popular tools that you can use or software that you can use that will help you build automation online. In this video, I talked about a few different sticking points in where these two software really diverge and where one of them comes out as a clear winner in terms of what it offers for its price. And, you know, spoiler alert, that was Integromat. But in the comments of that video, a few of you pointed out to me that I didn't really do justice to the differences between tasks and operations. Now, tasks and operations are the way that Zapier and Integromat respectively count the number of automation things that happen on your account. And I didn't really go into this enough, so thank you to you all who pointed that out, and let's solve that right here in this video. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I own Gap Consulting, a company that helps you to organize and automate your business with no-code tools. If you're interested in learning more about that and reclaiming more of your time, you definitely want to check out all the links below this video where I go through a bunch of different resources. But specifically, I'd love to invite you to join me for an upcoming webinar. I do a live weekly training where I teach the foundation of automation, and it saves me personally up to 20 hours per week. And I'm sure that so many people can benefit from this. So if you're one of them and you'd love to learn how to build automation to do your job and run your business, then you don't want to miss that. Even if you can't attend the training live, I'll send you a replay. So be sure to sign up using the link below. Visit me at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. But enough about all that. Let's jump into the heart of this. You know, we have to talk about Zapier Tasks versus Integromat Operations. Now, in order to really understand the difference between how tasks and operations are counted, what we first need to talk about is the foundational building blocks of automation. So every automation starts off with one trigger, and then every automation follows up with one or more action steps. So the trigger is simply the set of conditions or the condition that awakens the automation and tells it that it's time to automate. And once the trigger is awakened or once the trigger is pulled, then the actions are the things that the automation does. And this is at the core of Zapier Tasks and Integromat Automations. And it all comes down to how you build your automation. And in fact, I hope you stick around till the end because I'm going to go through how you can write better automations to take advantage of Integromat's lower pricing, especially with Airtable users. So let's jump into how Zapier counts tasks. You can actually check this out on Zapier's help docs on their own website, but you'll notice that tasks are counted for any successfully completed action step. So this would mean that if you have an automation that has a trigger and then five different action steps following that trigger, that you would be billed for five tasks every time the automation runs. The trigger does not count, but then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 action steps, assuming that all five of them were performed correctly. Now, by contrast, Integromat's operations are calculated very differently because of the way they interact with the trigger. As you see on Integromat support documentation, Integromat operations are counted every time a trigger searches for something. So if you have a trigger that's set up to go every 5 minutes, then that trigger would essentially be counted as a task 12 times every hour, even if nothing else on the automation happens. Because just having that trigger scan to see if there is a new record or those conditions are met, just having that trigger look for a possible automation to run, that counts as a task. So you absolutely have to consider this very big difference when you are building automation in the two platforms. Real quick interruption here, I do want to mention that Integromat was kind enough to give us a referral link. If in watching this video or any of our videos, you decide to start using more automation, it would be a huge help to the channel if you would use our referral link. It will give you 1 full month for free of the standard plan at Integromat, and we're going to get a little kickback for every dollar you spend after that. It will actually not cost you anything extra, but it's a nice way to show some thanks to the channel. So if that's of interest, do check the referral link below. So let's take an example scenario and determine how many tasks or operations would be consumed if we're running either Zapier or Integromat to perform the operation. Now for our example, I've built this inside of Integromat, but we can count the tasks that Zapier would use just the same. Very simple and straightforward automation here. Inside of our trigger, we see that we're connected to a base called Automation Triggers, and as soon as this field, last mod status equals done, is updated, every time that gets updated, that particular timestamp field, that is going to run our automation. But more importantly, if you click on the clock here, you'll notice the interval at which we are scanning our database to see if these conditions are met. So we are running this either at regular intervals, once, every day, days of the week, etc. The default setting here is regular intervals every 15 minutes, but you can set this as low as every minute to have your automation go out and search Airtable to see if it should be performing an automation. So that is an excellent feature because we can certainly build faster automations if we're looking every minute. But the thing to be aware of is that it's going to chew through a lot of your operation count. So the second part of this automation is simply to then check a box inside of that record. So let's go ahead and flip over into the actual database itself. Really simple for this example. The idea is we have a status field here. We have a last mod status, and this is simply looking at the status field to tell us when the last change was made to that status field. Then we're looking at a formula over here that's saying only when the status is done do I want to bring in the last mod status. So you can see that while we're always going to have a value in the last mod status if there is a status, but we will only get a date timestamp here in our last mod status equals done when the status is in fact done. Now we also have the record ID and we're passing this information along as well. And then we come back and check the box. So the idea being that when we move a status to done, that will update our last mod status, which will in turn trigger the automation and check the box. We can give this a run and come in and just test the automation. And we see that sure enough, it locates that new record and it updates that new record. And so we can go back and see that yes, it did check the box because we updated the status to done. So how many operations does this use in Integromat? From Integromat's perspective, this automation will use one operation at a minimum every 15 minutes. And that's because the automation is set up to look at our Airtable database every 15 minutes to determine if it needs to perform the automation again. So let's think about what this means for us in terms of consuming operation counts throughout the day. We have 24 hours in a day, and we run through four different triggering events every hour. Every 15 minutes, this is gonna go out there, so four times an hour. Four times 24 is 96. So we, at a minimum, use 96 operations every single day, just having this automation running in the background. And this is the big difference, because every time our automation actually finds a valid record that it needs to update with the checked box, then it's going to need to perform yet another operation. So it's 96 at a minimum, plus one more for every box checked that the automation has to perform every day. So if we were to assume that we had four different instances throughout the day where, in fact, we marked something as done and it then updated that checked box, that would be 96 different times that the automation looked, the trigger looked for a valid record, and four times that it found it and went on to step two, so four more operations there, so it would have performed a full 100 operations for one day. Now let's contrast that with the number of tasks that Zapier would consume. Zapier, as we discussed, does not count tasks for triggers. And so in the same exact instance, Zapier would only use four tasks. Zero triggers would be used, and only the four times that it had to actually do something would it count a task. So obviously this is a huge difference, and you can see how if you're decreasing your interval length, you can run through significantly more operations the more frequently your trigger is scanning. So what does this mean for us in terms of how we can write smarter automations for Integromat, knowing that we are going to chew through automations if we're watching records. Well, in short, it means that we can write a better automation using an immediate or instant trigger. Those immediate triggers that we build, they only count when the actual data is received. The big difference is we're not telling Integromat to go look at our database every 5 or 15 minutes. Instead, we're saying, hold on, we'll let you know when it's time to automate. So let's talk about the same automation, but built differently. Jumping into Airtable here, you can use a button. And with the button, you can set it up to open a URL and you can paste in a webhook. So here I've pasted in my Integromat webhook and I've appended it with ?record ID equals, and I'm adding on my record ID. This way, when I push the button, Integromat is going to know exactly what record ID I pushed the button from so that it can perform an automation for that record. And this automation is roughly the same as the last one, except we're not actually going out and looking at records in Airtable. We're waiting for data to come to that webhook. And so you can see that the settings for this are very different because the scenario runs immediately upon receipt of the webhook, and it's not going to go looking for something that doesn't exist. The only other difference here is what we do during the automation. So instead of just checking the box to update and say, yes, the automation is complete, we also need to mark the status as done. So it slightly changes the way that we work with the automation. In order to trigger the automation, we don't need to actually change the status. All we need to do is hit that box, marking the button, and as you see, the automation automatically checks that the automation ran and it updates the status to be done. So this way, we're able to write a better, more efficient automation that's going to chew through far fewer operational tasks within Integromat. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and let me know any questions you have below in the chat, and I will see you in the next video. As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.